Hey there, welcome to this week's Fast Key Fridays for Adobe Premiere Pro. In this week's episode, I'm going to give you some great keyboard shortcuts for audio editing and to help you get through your timeline faster than ever before. Hey there, I'm Mark Brown with Editor's Keys, and this is Fast Key Fridays for Adobe Premiere Pro CC. Now, if you use Premiere a lot, make sure you check out the full playlist up here or in the description in the link below. But this week, I'm going to give you a few shortcuts to help you get the best out of your audio and to help you speed up your editing through the timeline of Adobe Premiere Pro. So let's jump straight into it. The first shortcut I'm going to show you is very useful for when you have a really packed timeline and you want to match up all of your audio to be the same level. Simply just highlight all of your audio tracks, press the G key for audio gain, and then you can adjust the audio gain, normalize max peaks, and normalize all peaks. Really simple and a quick shortcut. The next shortcut is when you have a clip and for some reason the audio has been lost or deleted on your timeline. Instead of going into your project panel looking for the clip again, a quicker way to do this is to place your playhead over the clip. Make sure the track is targeted, hit your up arrow key to bring it to the beginning of the clip, and now press the F key. This will open up the clip in the source window with the audio, and all you have to do is drag the audio underneath the clip. So this shortcut is really useful for when you want to move around every clip that's in your timeline. Sometimes when you highlight the whole sequence, you can miss out certain clips without noticing and you could really mess up your edit. For this, just press the A key for track select, and this will select everything that's on the timeline that's in front of the cursor. If you want to deselect something, for example, the song you may be using for the edit, then just switch back to your selection by pressing the V key and holding the shift and then click the clip to deselect. To do the same thing, but in the opposite direction, hold Shift and A. The next shortcut is the slip tool. This is good for when you have a clip in your timeline, but you want to change the start and end points of the clip without moving any other clips. For this, just go to the Y key, go to your clips and click. Moving to the right will bring it back, and moving to the left will bring it forward. In the program sequence, the left side is where the clip will start and the right side is where the clip will end. Marker is a simple tool for remembering important parts of your timeline. To add a marker, simply press the M key. You can use this for so many different reasons, and if you look back onto our past videos, we've actually done a video on how you can use markers to quickly edit to the beat of your music within Premiere. It's very useful and will help make you more organized and make you better and quicker at editing than ever before. So there we go, that's this week's Premiere Pro keyboard shortcuts done. Now I really hope that's helping you to edit faster than ever before. And if it's the first time you've learned those shortcuts, let me know in the comments section below. Now we did mention in the tutorial about editing to the beat of the music, and if you want to see that video, you can click up here or check out the playlist in the description below and I'll give you a link directly to that video. But anyway, if you want to see next week's episode, and it's a good one, make sure you hit that subscribe, that like, and that notification bell, and I'll see you here next week.